Welcome back, everybody. Tom Eschen here on a Monday night. It's a new era in Cambridge, the Harvard Crimson hiring Jerry Byrne this summer after he spent 16 seasons as an assistant at Notre Dame. Here's what he has to work with from last year. The Crimson went 5-8, 1-5 in conference play. Did have a nice stretch in March. They beat Providence, BU, and Albany all in that month. Then April didn't go very well. Their season ended with 4 straight losses in April. They got a lot back. Their 12 leading scores. Yeah, I'm repeating that. Kyle Anderson, their leading scorer from a year ago, getting set for his senior year. As a junior, 44 points, the 14 assists were a career best for him. Austin McDronach was the second leading scorer as just a freshman a year ago. He had 35 points on 22 goals and 13 assists in the spring. The Culver alum, 2-time Ivy League Rookie of the Week. Not just offensive experience, but on the back end, too, most of their defense, plus goalie Kyle Mullen. The junior started every game last spring, made 22 saves in the win over Providence, 19 in the win over BU. Stopped 50.9% of the shots he faced. As mentioned, Jerry Byrne taking over the helm. He was known for his defense at Notre Dame. The Fighting Irish finished top 5 nationally in scoring defense 7 times in the last 13 years of his tenure. The best defense in the country twice in that time frame. I caught up with him at the IMLCA convention last month. Joined now by Jerry Byrne, a Harvard head coach. And coach, any different as a head coach now compared to an assistant coming back here every year?
You know, I think, coming back to the convention? Yeah. You go to a lot more meetings when you're the head coach. So, obviously much more responsibilities. So I was fairly engaged when I was an assistant, and as a head coach, you have much more responsibilities. You got your league meetings, you got your rule meetings, you got the general sessions. So I'm a lot more tired than I would typically be in past events. So, but it's great to be here.
Yeah. What did you what was the approach then in terms of what you wanted to take away to sort of get back to your team for the weekend?
I was telling my assistants that when you come to this event, you really have to have a strategy because our sport's so, one degree of separation that you can walk through the lobby of this hotel and you feel like you're walking into a high school party. You're constantly running into people. Some you want to see a little bit more than others. So, but having a plan when you're coming down to what are the manufacturers, your sponsors, your friends, your coaching mentors, guys you might have played in college or high school with. So I think having a really specific plan is critical. And I really asked our guys to do that. And so, some of the goals are that from a friendship and a professional development, and then trying to find 3 to 5 drills and 3 to 5 terms that we might try to roll into what we're doing.
Yeah, and I'm sure that goes both ways. Obviously, you're sharing things. Everyone else, it's sort of bouncing back on you. As you work, continue to build up to, the first game of at Harvard, what sort of was that vibe during fall ball for you guys? Was it teaching? Was it more of an attitude type thing as you work to start to make your mark on this program?
It's a bit overwhelming when you're coming in because you basically inherited each other. And so, you can make a really long list of the things that you'd like to do, but you have to start with, the Ivy League rules and the amount of practices we can have, and then we work backwards from there. So we started with, we know we're gonna have X number of practices, X number of interactions with them, and then basically built practice plans for each of those days, really specific, and try not to achieve too much. So we just wanted to have as much stickiness as possible. So, but by doing that, by focusing on the 5 to 7 things that are really critical, riding, clearing, substitutions, a fundamental defense, your basic offense, and the 10 to 15 terms that are fundamental to what you're trying to coach, then you can get to November and look back and say, all right, did we achieve that? So I think we tried to make it manageable while at the same time not overwhelming our guys and still making it fun and engaging and teaching them how to compete, and so that when we weren't around, that momentum and that personality that you were trying to transmit was still there when you left.
Yeah, and I know we had talked, you got the job, and in between that too, in terms of Harvard and the institution itself, what's it been like to sort of be a part of that world now over the last few months?
Oh my God, one of the things that you sometimes forget is, I was walking the other day from across the bridge, across the Charles into Harvard Square, and I'm walking through the Kennedy School, the government and public policy graduate program at Harvard, and there's a sign that says, speaker today. So I bop my head in, and Lech Walesa, who basically opened up Poland and the solidarity movement, the democracy movement in Poland. And so things like that are always happening at Harvard, and they don't, at most schools they'd be promoting it, but it's just the normal, you know, activities that happen at a place like Harvard. So I'm really kind of endorsing that with our guys, that they have to keep their eyes wide open or ears open to the things that
he's going to try to improve upon. This, they've been mainly 500 over the last half decade. 2014 was the last time they made the NCAA tournament. Other than that, one season over 500, and that was in 2018.